change, answer the call. On behalf of all the graduating practitioners, Blake is the mother of Jade and Penelope Bryant. She is a licensed realtor. Yes, let's hear it for the kids. She's a licensed realtor and owns a hair salon in the Playhouse District of Pasadena. Blake was introduced to religious science by her father, Malcolm Ali, and has been a proud member of Haya Center for Spiritual Living for the past 12 years. She is the co-creator of the Healing Shower, a spiritual tool designed to help individuals during tragic situations. Her motto is, God heals that which is ready to be healed. Let's have it be about my throat. Let's welcome Blake Payne.
Thank you, thank you. Namaste, beloved. Oh my gosh. I would just like to start by thanking all the family and friends for supporting the practitioner students throughout this process, which started well before 2 years ago. And next, I would like to continue in gratitude by acknowledging all the ministers and licensed practitioners who have truly been our backbone. Your encouragement and wisdom are a divine testimony of this philosophy. And lastly, the practitioner class of 2019, thank you for your courage to accept the call from God and say yes. I'm sure many of us questioned whether or not we were on the right path. I was unaware that becoming a licensed practitioner was a 2-year commitment. So I entered class with the built-in concept of what it meant to be a practitioner. And as my consciousness expanded, my idea of what it meant to be a practitioner expanded too. I'll never forget that first day in Prac 1 class, my teacher, Patricia Roach, saying, and I quote, "You have to do the work. If you don't do the work, you're not gonna make it." End of quote. At the time, I just thought she was talking about homework assignments. And I thought to myself, lady, calm down, what's the big deal? And as time progressed, I began to realize that this is what she meant. She meant this moment right here, for it is only by divine right cause that I am here standing right before you today. I am saying yes to a sacred commitment delivered from God. I am committing to be the force behind the force, the movement that creates the wind. Saying yes is examining your orange, which is a symbol of this thing called life, and beginning to peel away your race thoughts, false beliefs, knowing your trigger points, getting to that space of humility, and just being at peace with yourself. Because it's all God, it's all perfection, and we are one with God, so we are that perfection. And guess what? If your thoughts judge this perfection, it will show up in the form of a client. So we're gonna have to deal with it anyway. As practitioners, we must commit to being active, loyal, and supporting. You guys remember that? Not only to our spiritual communities, but to all communities. Science of mind is a way of life. We're committing to be present to this teaching at all times. Ernest Holmes, he created a faith that's open at the top. So that gives us the ability to be creative. But in our creativity, let us use science of mind as the frame that paints that picture. Let us continue to use that. You know, we're always saying we need a spiritual practice, and we do, we need that daily. Three that I use on a regular basis are prayer, affirmation, and meditation. And I just think it's up to us to become the great example as the master teacher Jesus the Christ is. Because if we do, others will follow. Ernest Holmes teaches in the Science of Mind textbook, and I quote, "A practitioner is one seeking to demonstrate the power of spiritual realization in everyday affairs. Should believe in divine guidance, he should affirm that his mind is continually impressed with the images of right action and that everything in his life is controlled by love, harmony, and peace, and that the eternal energy back of all things emanates everything which he undertakes." End of quote. So I would just like to leave the practitioner class with a prayer treatment. And so if everyone would just close their eyes if they so feel moved to do so. And just take a deep breath in and breathe in that love of God, knowing that there's one mind, one love, one peace, and that God is all there is, and that God always answers yes, and that we are one with God. God lives right here. He's a part of us. It's a part of us. Every single day walking with us, saying yes. And as I recognize that yes, I know that in every day of my life, I commit to saying yes. I commit to the sacred principles of Science of Mind. And as I commit to the principles of Science of Mind, I know that the practitioners graduating here today will do so as well. I show complete gratitude for knowing the life of God, and knowing that God is all yes. And as I know this, we all know this truth, no matter what we believe in, no matter what we call God, because he answers by so many names. And so I release my word into law, knowing that it is already done, knowing that all the answers have already been said to in the form of yes. And collectively we say, and so it is. Amen and amen. Namaste.